Although Starship's Flight 11 was incredibly successful, but did anyone else notice something strange that happened during the splashdown? What was that? Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. On October 13th, 2025, SpaceX achieved a significant milestone with the successful launch and completion of Starship Flight 11 from its Starbase facility in South Texas. This test flight, the 11th in the Starship program's full-scale integrated tests, marked the culmination of the version 2 V2 design phase for the upper stage and booster. Lifting off at 7:23 p.m. Eastern Time, the massive 404-foot-tall vehicle, comprising the Super Heavy booster and the Starship upper stage, designated Ship 38, demonstrated remarkable performance across ascent, separation, booster return, orbital coasting, reentry, and splashdown. While previous flights had grappled with propulsion failures, structural issues, and heat shield deficiencies, Flight 11 executed its objectives with precision, providing critical data for the upcoming version 3 V3 iterations. The flight not only validated improvements in engine reliability and control systems, but also pushed the boundaries of thermal protection, particularly with intentional modifications to Ship 38's heat shield tiles. The launch phase proceeded flawlessly, with all 33 Raptor engines on the Super Heavy booster igniting nominally to propel the stack skyward, generating over 16.7 million pounds of thrust, more than twice that of NASA's Saturn V rocket. Starship cleared the tower amid a plume of flame and smoke, ascending on a suborbital trajectory aimed at testing re-entry dynamics over the Indian Ocean. Unlike earlier tests plagued by engine outages or rapid unscheduled disassemblies, this ascent highlighted SpaceX's iterative refinements. The booster, reused from Flight 8 in March, incorporated an alternate engine configuration for its return burn, emphasizing reliability for future catch attempts at the launch tower. Stage separation occurred smoothly approximately 3 minutes into the flight, with the booster executing a boost-back burn to redirect it toward a splashdown zone in the Gulf of Mexico, just offshore from Starbase. The Super Heavy booster's performance during Flight 11 was a testament to SpaceX's progress in reusable rocketry. After separation, it reignited 13 of its Raptor engines for the initial deceleration, then transitioned to 5 engines for the intermediate phase, and finally to 3 for the landing burn, a deviation from the standard 3-engine setup used in prior flights. This configuration was designed to optimize control and reduce stress on the engines during the high dynamic pressure descent. Telemetry indicated a single engine anomaly during the relight sequence, but it did not compromise the booster's trajectory or stability. The booster achieved a soft splashdown in the Gulf, validating its guidance systems and providing data on water impact forces. While not recovered for reuse this time, the precision of the landing, within meters of the targeted coordinates, bodes well for upcoming attempts to catch the booster mid-air, using the launch tower's mechanical arms. SpaceX engineers noted that the booster's grid fins and attitude control thrusters performed exceptionally, maintaining orientation despite crosswinds and residual velocity. Shifting focus to the upper stage, Ship 38, this vehicle was purpose-built as a testbed for aggressive heat shield experiments. As the last V2 Starship to fly, it carried no payload beyond 8 mass simulators mimicking Starlink satellites, which were deployed during the coasting phase to simulate orbital insertion and release mechanics. Approximately 20 minutes into the flight, one of Ship 38's 6 Raptor engines, a vacuum-optimized variant, was relit briefly to adjust its trajectory, ensuring a steeper re-entry angle that would mimic conditions for future returns to the launch site. This maneuver was executed without issue, demonstrating improved propellant management and ignition reliability compared to earlier flights where fuel sloshing or valve malfunctions had caused problems. The re-entry phase was where Flight 11 truly shone, particularly in evaluating Ship 38's heat shield. SpaceX intentionally removed large patches of ceramic heat shield tiles from strategic locations across the vehicle's belly and sides, exposing underlying structures to extreme plasma heating. These emissions, often in groups of four tiles rather than singles as in previous tests, were concentrated in high heat flux areas, such as along the centerline and near the flaps. Some spots lacked even the backup ablative layer, leaving bare stainless steel to face temperatures exceeding 2,600 degrees Fahrenheit. The goal was to stress test the limits of the vehicle's thermal protection system, TPS, gathering data on how plasma intrusion affects internal components like tanks and feed lines. Onboard cameras captured the intense orange and purple glow of re-entry plasma enveloping the ship, but unlike Flight 10, where significant flap damage and tile loss occurred, Ship 38 maintained structural integrity throughout. A key innovation tested on Ship 38 was the expanded use of crunch wrap material, a flexible ablative sealant designed to fill gaps between tiles and prevent hot gas ingress. Introduced in limited form on Flight 10, this material was applied more extensively here, particularly around flap hinges and tile edges prone to erosion. Post-flight analysis from drone footage revealed discoloration in orange and white hues on the heat shield, indicative of oxidation on metallic test tiles and exposed insulation where tiles were absent. Despite these stresses, the main heat shield structure remained intact, with no catastrophic burn-through observed. However, closer examination of released videos showed small flames venting from the payload bay and between the aft flaps, phenomena not present in Flight 10. Experts speculate this could result from minor punctures in tanks or lines due to plasma penetration in tileless areas. Yet the ship still achieved a controlled descent. Issues noticed during the landing sequence provided further insights into Ship 38's resilience. As the upper stage transitioned from its belly flop orientation to vertical for splashdown, its three sea-level Raptor engines ignited precisely, gimbaling to stabilize the vehicle. Drone angles captured the flip maneuver in detail, showing the ship descending stably from an altitude of about 4.2 kilometers at 415 kilometers per hour, slowing to a near hover before touching down in the Indian Ocean, roughly 66 minutes after launch. The splashdown was soft, with the ship tipping over gradually without immediate explosion, allowing for extended data collection. Still frames from the footage highlighted damage to the aero cover, a protective layer over flap mechanisms, which appeared in tatters, with sheets of metal barely attached and tiles ripped off. Burn-through was more pronounced on the body than in Flight 10, aligning with the intentional tile removals. One notable anomaly was the fire emanating from the payload bay, which puzzled observers. The bay, typically pressurized with nitrogen, should not support combustion, suggesting a possible leak of gaseous methane from the autogenous pressurization system or header tank. Discussions on platforms like X highlighted this, with users noting it could stem from burn-through in midline tile patches. Despite this, the flames did not impair control, and the flaps, both forward and aft, held up remarkably well. The forward flaps, redesigned in V2 for better leeward positioning and thinner profiles, showed minimal damage, reinforcing their reliability for reuse. The aft flaps, historically vulnerable to plasma erosion, exhibited only superficial stress, a vast improvement over Flight 10's sizable chunks missing. The intentional stressing of Ship 38's tiles yielded invaluable data. By removing patches in critical zones, SpaceX simulated worst-case scenarios to understand failure modes. Pre-launch photos revealed dozens of missing tiles, some exposing bare steel, which during re-entry led to localized heating and venting. Yet, the vehicle's ability to survive and perform the landing flip underscores the robustness of the underlying stainless steel structure. Elon Musk noted post-flight that the data would accelerate V3 development, where tiles might be further optimized or replaced with advanced materials. Comparisons to earlier flights show progressive enhancements. While Flight 10 landed 3 meters off target with flap damage, Flight 11's accuracy, though not publicly quantified, appeared spot on based on pre-positioned buoys and drones. Problems faced during Flight 11 were minor compared to the program's history. The booster's engine glitch was the only reported hiccup, likely due to startup transients in the new configuration. For the ship, the venting and aero cover tearing highlight areas for refinement, but these were anticipated given the experimental tile setup. No major structural failures occurred, and the dynamic banking maneuver, simulating return to base trajectories, worked as intended, adjusting the descent path to stress different heat shield sections. Looking ahead, Flight 11 paves the way for V3 Starships, which will feature stretched tanks, more powerful engines, and potentially hinged payload doors for rapid deployment. SpaceX aims to attempt ship catches at Starbase in upcoming tests, requiring even greater precision. The data from Ship 38's tiles will inform TPS upgrades, possibly integrating more crunch wrap or metallic variants to achieve rapid reusability, essential for Mars missions and Starlink constellation growth. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.